Well, the day has arrived, folks. I've been putting this off for a little while, and I guess a few of you may have been wanting to see the Donahue grain trailer here get its third axle put under it. So, it's Sunday afternoon. It's mildly warm, I guess in the upper 60s, nice day. So, I got some other things I need to be doing, but I'm just going to go ahead and get this third axle put under here hopefully today. I'll probably get it all done, but I'll at least get it mounted maybe, and maybe get the tires on it. But anywho, I told you I would do video of that as I got it done, and or as I did it. So that's what we're gonna do today. So first things first, I've got it here in front of the shed. I'm going to try to get all the tools and stuff out that I need. I still haven't hooked to the truck at the moment. I'm about to unhook it from the truck. What I'm gonna do is hopefully use this hydraulic jack on the front to my advantage. So I'm gonna move the back axle first. I'm gonna slide it to the back. Well, I'm actually gonna remove these mud flaps first because I gotta do that. Get the mud flaps off, and then I'm going to unbolt this back axle. I'm going to use some jack stands underneath the axle. I've actually got an idea, hopefully, if I got enough height on my, or my jack stands are low enough, on how I'm going to slide that back. But I'm going to try to leave the wheels on it, unhook it from the truck, use the jack up front to lower the trailer using this axle as my pivot, to take the weight off this axle just enough so that I can slide it back to these next holes right under here. And then I'll do kind of the reverse thing for the next axle. I'll actually lift the trailer till this axle is just loose enough that I can move it back to the next holes. And if that all works well, I'll come in here with the new axle on or strapped to my pallet jack somehow, and I'll get it slid under here as far as I can get it. I may have to drag it a little bit. I'll put some cardboard or something down there on the ground, and I'll use a couple of jack stands and get it propped up to where I can get it bolted on. And then all to be left to do then is rehook up the electric brakes and move these. I got to move these mud flaps back, and I hadn't decided exactly how I'm going to do that yet, but I'll get that axle moved back first and see how that goes. So yeah, that's the plan for this afternoon, to get this this third axle put on. So stay tuned here, and I'll maybe high speed you through some footage of this happening. Battery charger up for them. Cutting the wires for the brakes. It bolted on there too. Something loose in the ground wires and bolts on. Okay, so what I'm doing right now is cutting these trailer brake wires. You can see there's a red wire in it, but I done snipped it on both sides here. That one snipped too. But they're also bolted here, so I'll have to do a little rewiring here possibly after I move this axle. But I'm gonna get these unbolted. I'll have to do the same for that axle up there as well. That close. Alright, next thing I'm gonna do, get these mud flaps off. One mud flap removed. number two. Gets number two off. Alright, so here's what I've got. I've got these two jack stands here placed as close to dead center of the trailer here as I could. And I've got this piece of square tubing. I actually had a solid round rod about the size I was looking for that I wanted to use for this, but I couldn't find it, so this will have to do. But my hope here is I'm gonna, like I said, leave the wheels on. I'm gonna unbolt that axle and let it ease down on this steel tubing here, and then just take each wheel and work it back here to the next holes and bolt it back up from there. And again, using the jack, hydraulic jack up front to bring the trailer up and down, and that's what we're gonna do. We're gonna try it anyway, so stay tuned. Thank you. Well, I got them two moved. Now to bring in the new one. Alright folks, about to get this axle on here. Well, it's actually on there, I just got to put the tires on now. But anyway, there it is. Got it bolted up, just a little planning ahead with the forklift there. Saved me a little time. I thought if I could get this thing in here and close enough to the holes like I did, I could get a bolt or two in it, and then it wouldn't be too much of a problem from there on out. So anyway, it bolted up good, holes all lined up, so that's all good stuff. Just gotta throw these tires on there. That's that hub I gotta fix there. I've got a new hub. Just thought I'd wait till I had the wheels and all on it in case I bumped it or something and damaged it putting it on, but like I said, I received it that way. But anyway, I was gonna paint it red, but as heavy as it is, it was gonna be a hassle, so I just thought I'd just leave it black. But anyway, I'll get some tires around here and get them on so you can see what this thing looks like with these three axles and six tires. Folks, there it is with tire on. Went on there right as expected. Kind of lines up with the inside of these tires. So let you have a look at it there. But anywho, looks about right, other than it being a little narrower, which I've already been through that saga in a previous video. But anyway, I just gotta put the other one on now and get the brakes wired back up and then get the mud flaps on. I don't know if I'll get to the mud flaps today, but there it is, third axle on there finally. So maybe that'll do the job. See ya.